It'll be hard to get him with Danielle around.
Yeah, we'll figure something out. Let's just go.
Squirrels.
It's not like I eat the squirrels, even though they taste good. And even if I did, it's not like I'm committing crime or anything.
God, Danielle's such a little bitch. She'll care about her stupid TV show.
Yeah, I know. It's probably the only show in history to ever receive negative ratings.
Yeah, right. Anyways, we gotta find a way to distract Timon and Pumbaa over there so we can talk to Jack.
How?
Oh, I don't know. If only one of us could turn invisible at will, that would be oh so very helpful to create a distraction. I hate how those take your clothes off when you do that.
I don't have to take my clothes off. But I did. I'm sorry.
Did you just snap my bra strap?
In your dreams, Danielle.
I was staring at the beetle. It's another one off my checklist.
Yeah, whatever.
No, I did not!
Yeah, you did!
I did not do anything!
There it is again!
What are you doing? I'm not doing anything!
Stop touching me!
I'm not touching you!
You're touching me!
I'm not!
What the... What the hell? Come with me, Jack.
What?
I said, come with me. Look, I'm a vampire.
What are you talking about?
I'm a vampire.
You're a vampire.
Holy shit, you're a vampire?
Vampire. Nice.
Now, are you gonna tell me your little secret, wolf boy?
What do you just call me?
Look, we're all adults here, and we know you're a werewolf.
We?
I'm Charles. And yes, she said we. As in, the uniquely able. Namely, me, Victoria, and you.
Alright, dude, why the hell are you naked?
Alright, man, that's not important right now. I tried to tell you I was a ghost earlier. You wouldn't listen, and this is the only way to let you know. Alright, just have my dick in your face.
He's a perv. Get used to it.
Look, but like she was saying earlier, we understand that you're a werewolf.
How do you guys know? Are my claws showing? I mean, they usually only come out on the night of the full moon, but other than that, I'm fine.
Well, we wanted to warn you about that Danielle Glick girl.
Dude,
from
her
class.
Boobs are fucking huge.
Yeah, I know.
Yeah, everyone's seen her boobs.
Everyone except me.
Her boobs are out, she gets her inside scoops. She'll do anything for the story. Anything. And if you don't want to end up like Frankenstein...
Dead.
Then you should stick with us.
We can offer you a certain type of protection.
I only need protection during a full moon. It's when I become a werewolf. We're not in school after dark. I don't need you to.
Listen. The only way we're going to get through this is if we stick together. The worst thing in high school is be different. Well?
Fine. I'm in.
Oh. Yeah, we're a team!
That's absolutely right, Stephen. That's a fantastic observation. All through the history and narrative, there are several tragic figures we should be aware of. For example, Macbeth, Jay Gatsby, Kathy Lee Gifford is a good one. And I think we can add one more to that list, and that's Frankenstein. Now, does anyone want to take a stab at why Frankenstein is considered such a tragic, tragic figure? Yes, Danielle?
Mr. Dover, I think one of the reasons why Frankenstein is so tragic is that no matter how hard he tries to hide, it's inevitable that he gets caught by the villagers and fails in the end. He can't belong in society because he's such a freak. And therefore, he dies.
That's absolutely right. You couldn't be more right because why? Freaks always die. not so fast, everybody. It's
Every Tuesday, Dr. Dover makes us stay late to write these movie evaluations.
Yeah, we have to watch a movie and then write a paper about it.
Today, we'll be dealing with the apartment. Ticks.
Anything but that.
Sex-charged story of a lonely man. And a sexy, sexy elevator operator.
You know, I have an apartment.
I like it. Really? And you wouldn't be ashamed to be seen with somebody?
What? It looks as if the power's gone out, ladies and gents. So we're gonna have to finish this film later, but what I'd like for you to do is just write your papers on X1 and 2 of the apartment.
Ladies and gentlemen, I present to you the administrator, formerly known as Prince Napole.
Hello, students. The weather is so putrid, the rain, the storm. You're going to be trapped in the school all night.
What?
What?
Yes. But don't worry. No. I'll be in my office if you need me. See you later, bitches.
No.
Oh, my God. What am I supposed to do for dinner?
Oh, Victoria, calm down. I'm sure they'll be able to open up a cafeteria or something.
Charles, you know I can't eat that.
Yeah, Victoria, it's not that bad, but... Okay, well, human blood probably does taste better than that shit.
Gotta get out of here, guys.
I'm sure they have some ramen or something in the freezer.
No, it's not that. Tonight's the night of the full moon.